Good morning, how are you? It is super early, 7 o'clock-ish. Saquica is just there behind me, I don't know if you can see it. But I am taking myself out on a little walk slash run. A little tour around Montmartre where we're staying. Stephen's still asleep and we're so different when we're travelling. Like, he likes to sleep in. I like to get up in the morning and just like get on with stuff. So I've decided I've got like a few little spots on my map that I want to go and sort of visit. So that's what we're gonna go and do. Okay, so my first stop was this metro station. I read a blog and someone said it's like one of a really pretty metro station. Bit disappointed, to be quite honest. This is what it looks like. It's not that pretty, I don't think. I mean, well, it's nice, but yeah, never mind, on to the next place. I've gotta say, this is not the easiest part of Paris to walk around. It's very hilly and steppy. But I found my next spot. It's Le Bateau Lavoir, which is with a studio where artists like Picasso used to come and work. Look at this place. Can you appreciate how hilly it is around here? That's where we've just seen the artist studio there. Very hilly. I might wander down that street actually. The sun's just coming up. I should have gone up for, if you watched yesterday, I went for sunrise up at Sacré-Cœur. I should have gone today. It looks much nicer sky today. Never mind. I'm gonna wander down here though. It takes me off route a little bit, but, well, it takes me like roundabout, but never mind. Look at the colour of that sky. It looks like it's going to be a much nicer day in Paris today than the rainy, wet, cloudy, horrible one we had yesterday. I'm back at Sacré-Cœur, and look, it's a much nicer sunrise today, never mind. There's Sacré-Cœur. This house is the famous sunken house of Paris. You may or may not have heard of it, but you can only get a shot of it from a certain angle. So hopefully I can come back. The gardens where you need to get the shot from is closed at the moment, so open to 8. I think I've got a few more bits to do. I'll come back and try and get it. Now that's Sacré-Cœur, I'll just walk behind it. This might give you a bit of perspective of how high up we are. Right, so many steps, so high. But it does give some amazing views over the city. Here we have the Museum of Montmartre. I'm not going in, in fact, I think it's closed. Yeah, there's some paintings, some Renoir paintings and things in there. Possibly, yeah, Renoir. These are the artists that are in there. These ones. What an absolutely adorable little street the museum's on as well. Check that out. The street I've just walked down, which has the museum on, and then just at the end is this famous cute little cafe restaurant, La Maison Rose. I don't know how you say it. How cute is it? Okay, I'm gonna head back now. I haven't seen half the places that I wanted to see, but I kind of misjudged how far apart they all were. I'm gonna go back down through Sacré-Cœur, down the gardens there, and try and get a shot of this sunken house, and I'll show you what I mean. You have to excuse the state of my hair. I haven't brushed it yet this morning, and it's quite windy. The best thing, I think, about coming back to a city that you've already been to is, like I've been here twice before, is that you've kind of done the main touristy attractions. So you can spend time just like wandering the streets and seeing like the back alleys and stuff. And I so love that side of the cities. And this area in particular, Montmartre, is so lovely to come. It's all like cobbled streets and little alleyways. So, so nice. Like, see behind me, there's a little square where artists are setting up and Sacré-Cœur's there. So, so pretty, this little area of Paris. It has like a nice little village feel to it. Back at Sacré-Cœur, I need to get some pictures of it with the blue sky behind rather than the grey one was yesterday. But I was wrong about the sunken house. You don't have to go into the gardens. The gardens just on there, but you don't need to. You can get them from this stop here. Look. So there you go. See, if I zoom in, you can see you've got to put your camera on a little angle. and get the shot. But if you zoom out, you can see that's how it normally looks. Okay, I'm heading back to the hotel now. It's gotten quite late. I need to go and get some breakfast before we head out for the day. See, look how much I've done. This one's still asleep. We're finally out. We're out a little bit later than we were yesterday, but just watched Stephen with my phone. In contrast to yesterday, it is a beautiful, beautiful day in Paris today. Clear blue skies. I think the plan is like to go to some of the gardens and things, because obviously we couldn't yesterday. It was pissing down all day. Okay, our plan at the moment is to, we're just walking to Gare du Nord, and then we're gonna go over to Jardin de Luxembourg, I think. Gardens are just behind us, but before we go, we're just going to head up. We're near the Pantheon, something like that. Look at the big tower. You can go up to the top, and apparently you can get some cool views over Paris. And seeing as our views yesterday from the Arc de Triomphe were kind of rainy and cloudy and horrible, I think we're going to try and get up high today and get some nice views with blue skies. So we're just going to head there for a little bit first. Oh, this is it. The Pantheon. Bigger than I thought it was going to be. So normally it would be €9 to get in, but I can get in with my museum pass, and Stephen's free because he's under 18. What is it? Do you know? Whoa.
I want to know what charting means.
Oh, it really does go all the way up, like on a string. Charting.
Charting.
I have no idea. I feel like maybe I've got this place completely wrong.
Yeah.
I was sure that you could get up to the top, but maybe you can't. I don't know. We're gonna go and see. Oh no, yeah, look, no, you can't go up.
Okay.
You can go down. Okay, let's go down then. Keep going. What? No. We're down in the crypt. I don't know how much I like being down here, to be quite honest. It's not the nicest of places to be. Where we will. It goes very far. I don't know whether we can get up this way. It's like a maze down here, isn't it? We definitely could get lost, easy. It looks like it's a mirror, like when you've got a mirror. Whoa. Oh look, Marie Curie. Stephen said this is the worst thing ever. Seems I was wrong, whatever I was reading. About, oh yeah, school, but just hang on a second. Seems I got it wrong. You can't go up it. I don't know what I read that said that you can go up this. But we can't. We can't find what you do anyway, so we are leaving. There is a nice view when you walk out though. Look, the Eiffel Tower. See that bit there at the very top? That's the bit that I thought you could get to and have like spectacular views over Paris. I'm going to Google it when we get back to the hotel. Okay, here we are. Whoa, they're digging it up. Hey man, what's wrong with you? trying to find? We're still in the gardens.
Lunch.
Is that the good? We're trying to find. Last time we came here, Stephen played basketball over there with some kids. And we remember finding this like little park area, but it was closed. We're sure it's around here somewhere. You okay? So we're just trying to find it. Yes, it is here, look. We found it. Whoa, it's really big. It's bigger than I remember. 11. Oh, look, you have to pay. £2.50 for kids. It wasn't too bad, it was like, what, £3.70 for the two of us to get in? And it's quite good. Look. How cool is this? It goes all the way around. Hang on. Woo! Yeah, there you go. Wow, that's so cool. Is it hot? Now we're gonna head over to, to the Louvre, maybe see what the queues are like. It's about 1 o'clock, so it might be like peak queue time, but I've never been in. We've been like around it, but I've never actually been in. It'd be nice to go in, kind of just see the Mona Lisa really, and it's kind of like one of those things that you kind of should do, but I don't know. Whoa, look at this that we've just discovered on our walk. That's pretty epic. It is. This in the middle is the Massilian, and that behind is Saint-Sulpice. We're just at the river. One of the things we haven't done actually is have a little walk down the river. Not that it was nice enough yesterday to do that at all. One of my favourite things about Paris is the river. And like the little like bookstalls and things along the side. I just think it's just so, so adorable. Look at this courtyard.
It's massive.
It is so
biggest courtyard.
So massive. I think it is actually the museum. Here we are. Let's see what the queue's like. There's pretty much no queue at all. Hardly. Yeah, look, normally it could be like all weaving in and out here. Stephen doesn't want to go. Okay, we're in, but maybe there is some queues once you get inside. Let's go and have a look. I don't know what I expected, but this is not kind of what I expected inside. We're just underneath the glass pyramid at the moment, and then it just goes off into all different sections. I think we're literally just going to go and see if we can see the Mona Lisa. Well signposted all throughout the museum, tells you where it is. She's up a lot of steps as well. enormous. I really didn't realise it was this big. If I was by myself, I would definitely spend more time here, but it's not Stephen's thing at all, and I don't feel like you could literally spend hours and hours. It's in here, Mona Lisa's in here. Oh, it's not actually that busy. I was going to say it'd be heaving, but look, it's not too bad.
That's a massive train.
Oh my god.
Mona Lisa is number 4189.
So there we go, we've seen the Mona Lisa. Stephen is not impressed whatsoever. He'd rather have this painting.
Apart from the size.
Apart from the size, yeah, that's huge. But yeah, it is crazy how it's just such a thing. Found his favourite thing in the museum. Why is the guy stabbing his eye? Anyone know? Oh look, this is it. Oh, it doesn't say it in English.
It's spider.
Oh, look at this. As you're coming out of the Louvre, there's like an inverted pyramid. Underground for a bit, we couldn't find the way out. We found the exit now. Stephen found it, yeah, because Stephen finds everything. I don't find anything ever because I'm useless. We're in Tuileries Gardens now. We're going to try and grab a seat over there. We've got a bit of food. Stephen's got a Mackey's. I've got a slice of pizza. I'm going to sit down and have a little relax for a second. I have a little story to tell you about these chairs. Am I allowed to tell them
this
story? Oh, I'm not allowed to tell you this story from when we were last here. Very funny. Sorry, I can't tell you. Maybe when he's not here, I might just secretly tell you. We'll see. Oh, how nice is this for a little lunch spot? Apart from the pigeons are coming and trying to eat Stephen's food. But nice. Okay, we've eaten our lunch. I think the plan now, we were just discussing what to do. We're gonna head back to the hotel for a little bit. I've got tons of work to do. And it's just quite tiring, isn't it? All this like city sightseeing. So we just kind of want a little bit of a rest. So we're gonna head back. And like the plan last night was to come back out, but then as you saw, it was piddling down last night. So we're gonna come back out, hopefully for sunset at the Eiffel Tower. Okay, we were back at the hotel for a little bit. We've now come out. We were at Trocadero. Trocadero? I don't know how you say it. I think that's how you say it. Station, and we are going to the Eiffel Tower. It's about 6 o'clock or something like that. And sunset is at 6:34. There's the Eiffel Tower. It is super crazy busy there. Maybe I was going to come here at sunrise, but never actually made it. It's too far away from the hotel. First, we need to find a baguette from somewhere. Okay, we got some snacks. We got a baguette. And some crisps. We're gonna go and sit in front of the Eiffel Tower for a little bit now. But yeah, the sun sets at the other side. So I don't know. But we wanna see it at night anyway with the twinkly lights. Okay, we found our spot on the wall. Stephen's just eating a baguette. The Eiffel Tower is there. Just gonna sit and wait for it to go dark now.
Okay.
Do you think it's going to twinkle at 7?
Yeah. It should do because it's getting
right,
dark.
Right, it is 6:51. The Eiffel Tower twinkles on the hour for 5 minutes, and that's what you want to see. Hopefully it twinkles at 7. It should be dark enough. We've got 1 minute, hopefully.
Oh.
It's gonna twinkle. Please twinkle Eiffel Tower. It's not that cold. Oh, yay! You twinkled!
That's not that good.
Yay, Twinkly was cool, it's finished now. It was cool, excuse my hat by the way. This is just, I found this hat and I just pinched it because I was so cold.
It took an hour and a half.
Yeah. Stephen's not impressed, but never mind. Should we go home or should we go and do something else? Stephen just wants to go back. Going home? I think I'm just going to end the vlog here because we're just going just go back to the hotel. Probably do a bit of packing because we are leaving Paris tomorrow, unfortunately. It's been very nice. I can probably spend quite a few more days here, but we are off to a new destination. So, we'll see you in the morning. Say goodnight, Stephen.
Goodnight.
Can you end it? I've got no hands.
Oh, okay.
Goodnight.